What if I told you that every movement of mouse or click that you do can be detected using this USB sniffer device? Mouse is connected to this device, and this side is connected to computer. Or we can connect a keyboard to the sniffer, and whatever is typed, we can read it. So even the password can be read here, because it passes through this, and we can read it from this port. This USB sniffer is sold on Banggood for $33.99 at the moment, with $4 shipping. So here's the package. We get a USB-C cable. And we got two of them, actually. And this, on this side, we have this female with male USB-A connector, and then the USB-C. This goes towards PC. So this USB sniffer acts as a pass-through, meaning when I connect the mouse, it comes, and from here we can connect it to our computer. And now the mouse is active, it just passes through. But we read the signal on that is passing via this port, and this will be connected to a computer where we use Wireshark. But this can be connected to the same computer or different computer, it does not matter, but the signal that passed through, we can read it from here. It is inside this module, the two USB ports that we are connecting with these FPGA pins, and this goes to the device, to your computer via Wireshark. The code, the board, all the firmware is made possible by Alex Taradov. He provided all the software, including the firmware, and including the manufacturing PCB Gerber file, so you can produce your own. But of course, it involves some printing and soldering and some command line, but the one that I'm providing is already comes with a firmware. You don't need anything, you just start using it, which I'm going to show you. Here is the wiring to connect a mouse to your computer to do the sniffing, like this. And if you want to connect a keyboard, like this. But if you have any other device, it will be just connected to this port. The rest is exactly the same. First, let's download the Wireshark. And this is a website. Depending on your operating system, for most Windows computers, this would be the option. I've downloaded this twice, so run it. So go with all defaults up to here. And I've already installed it, so it's grayed out. This is not necessary. But this one, you must check it. Right now, I've already installed it, so make sure that you check this and continue. Without this, you cannot use it. Now we need to install the USB sniffer for Windows. I will provide you the link. And you will come to robojax.com and download it from here. The link will be provided below this video. Once you download it and you will extract the zip file, inside it you will have USB sniffer Windows, which is this file. Then go to your C. We will copy the executable, that .exe, right click, copy, come here, right click, paste. Now the software installation is completed. Let's run the program, and as you can see, this is connected. The mouse is already here, and you see the mouse is turned on. Okay, the software is ready, and here the mouse is also connected. I can see USB sniffer here, and then click on this icon beside it, and from this menu make sure to select low speed and click start. Right now, as you can see, it prints all these syslog and nothing else shown. When you see syslog, it means there is no USB activity or anything. And we can filter the data by typing USB LL. You see here, when it does USB LL, you don't see right now anything. Perhaps it's not connected. Let's just disconnect, unconnect it, and you see USB LL is shown. Now we see, I can stop it so we can explain. I use this row is called filter. I type USB LL, so I typed it. I typed USB LL to filter all the data that is coming because it will spit so much information. So we have N, and if I click here, I can see some information here, and NAC. So these information are coming from USB LL. One is from computer, and then the other one is from mouse. Let's run the program, and as you can see, this is connected. The mouse is already here, and you see the mouse is turned on. Okay, the software is ready, and here the mouse is also connected. I can see USB sniffer here, and then click on this icon beside it, and from this menu make sure to select low speed and click start. Right now, as you can see, it prints all these syslog and nothing else shown. When you see syslog, it means there is no USB activity or anything. And we can filter the data by typing USB LL. You see here, when it does USB LL, you don't see right now anything. Perhaps it's not connected. Let's just disconnect, unconnect it, and you see USB LL is shown. Now we see, I can stop it so we can explain. I use this row is called filter. I type USB LL, so I typed it. I typed USB LL to filter all the data that is coming because it will spit so much information. So we have N, and if I click here, I can see some information here, and NAC. So these information are coming from USB LL. One is from computer, and then the other one is from mouse. Now, and clicking to continue. You see, when I move the mouse, let me stop it. When I move the mouse, we saw some activity here. You see data one, and if I click here, you see, we see the mouse. Data zero, data one, and then data zero, data one. These are the data from our mouse. We can use this filter to filter it out. So we say the PID should be 03 or 04. You see 03 data 0 here. And then if I click on the other one, it says 04B. So here it says USBLL.PID when it is equal 0X3 or 0X4B. Now if I enter it, let's activate it. So I'm moving the mouse and explain the value for you. I'm not clicking or anything, it's just movement of the mouse. Now, let's see. 0x. These are all the position of a mouse. Here are the data for mouse. So the first one is report ID, and then we have buttons, this one, and then position of X of mouse and position of Y of mouse. And all these all will be part of a data. And the data is in here. Here. So 2, 6, 2, 4, 6 and 7. The bit 6 and 7 are for X. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 5, 0. This bit is our data 0, 5. And if I go here, you see 2, 4, 6 and 8. So we have also X and Y, C0. So the mouse has moved. Now let me connect the keyboard. This is a wired keyboard. So I'm disconnecting the mouse and connecting the keyboard. So let's do this data here. Data second bit. And now this is only keyboard. So let's press A, and I'm pressing. Pay attention here, this is 9736. One more line we have. And then one more, I'm going to press B. So we got second line, 393. Let's get this value. It says, as I mentioned, it's 00004. So data here with a little space. So pay attention to this 04 here. 04 is A. The A will be uppercase and lowercase depending on shift. So it's the same letter except with a shift. So 0x04 is here. We pressed it and the first byte, second, this is a third byte for keyboard. The same way, the same byte should be 05 for B when I press it. You see 05, that's B, and that's A. And let's press K. Pay attention to this 173372, the last line. Oh, I'm at the top. It's stopped, let's run it. Now let's press K. So K is printed. And as you can see, the value is 0E. Let's see in our list. K is 0E. So here you go. You are able to read any keyboard value, including, let's check now, I'm running now the, let's press F12. You see that's F12, 4, 5. Now let me type the word password and see what it is, because if somebody places a USB sniffer between your keyboard and the computer, you can read all the password. Nothing is encrypted. So, PASSWRD.